friends, how you all doing? Welcome back to the channel and welcome to a fresh episode of FM19's The Hall of Famer. And we come to our season ending review episode. Yes, we've already done one of these when we're in charge of Vanesborg, and we are now going to do one as we've just finished the first 5 to 6 months in charge of Bandırmaspor. Above, my friends, is last episode. I don't want to give anything away before we crack on with this review episode. Please go and watch that. It was the playoff final. We've got a lot to talk about in today's episode. We've obviously got to take a quick look at the manager's screen, see how we're getting on, see how the stats are faring and what our win-loss record is like. We need to take a look at the Hall of Fame. We need to study the player's stats. We need to talk about next season and what's going to happen with the series going forward. So let's do our season review 2.5 with Bandırmaspor. So ladies and gentlemen, let's start here, shall we? Let's take a look at the league table. Let's take a look at all the stats from the league. We're going to take a look at, obviously, the awards from the league. We're also going to take a look at the club's personal awards that are voted for by the fans and all that good stuff. We've got a lot to get through in today's episode. We will finish by looking at the manager's screen and the Hall of Fame. So if you want to look at that, obviously, you're going to have to wait to the end of the episode or just skip forward, whatever you want to do. But anyway, let's talk about the league season, shall we? Now, the most phenomenal part of this season with Bandırmaspor is that we only took over in January, the 19th of January, I believe it was, that we took over. It's now obviously the 1st of June in the game. And when we took over, we were 15th in the league. We did not look like we stood a chance in hell, but what a run we went on with this football club. 63 points we ended with. We're going to take a real good look at that league table in more detail very, very shortly. But we have, as you can see right there, gone up through the playoffs. Ladies and gents, let's take a look at the stats now, shall we? Now, as far as the goals are concerned, we don't have a player in the top goal scorers chart. Well, not in the top three anyway. But if we do take a quick look, you will see that Haluk Tekeri, the old man himself at 33, managed to score 14 goals this season. And he scored a lot of them after I took over. Playing him as that target man on support really did suit him. And the other man as well, that they struck up such a good partnership, Murad Han Gonan, who was on loan with us this season, 9 goals in the league. What a partnership that is. Beautiful, beautiful effort from the two boys. You'll see, as far as the average ratings are concerned, that Erdem Yilmaz has drawn the average ratings, but has been given a first. He really is a phenomenal talent, it has to be said, a very young player. As far as other players to get in this list, you'll see that Baturay, Haluk Tekeri, Sian, they're all in there, all doing very, very well this season. As far as the assists are concerned, we're not in the top three, but we do have a couple of players in the assists. You'll see that Sian is joint sixth and Erdem down in joint 11th. The thing about Erdem is he didn't really start playing, full games until I took charge. He was a bit of a bit part player, but one for the future, definitely. Player of the match, not in the top three once again. But you'll see that Baturay Haluk Tekeri did manage to get in there down in joint 16th place. As far as clean sheets are concerned, the goalkeeper didn't get in the top three, but you'll see that Evren is joint 8 with a few. Managed to keep 9 clean sheets this season. Very, very impressive from the sweeper keeper. And as far as the yellow cards, the red cards, all that good stuff, I'm glad we're not in the top list of that. It means that our discipline really did improve. But what a phenomenal effort from the boys to go all the way and get their self-promotion to the TFF First Division. Let's take a quick look, though, at the league table in all its glory before we move on to the awards, ladies and gentlemen. So as I've already said, we were 15th in the table when I first took over. We were there. That's pretty incredible to think that we went all the way up here. We finished after 34 games with 17 wins, 12 draws and only 5 losses. We went on a streak of 18 games without defeat, which was pretty incredible. We scored 54 goals and only 2 clubs in the league scored more than that this season. And we conceded 35. I believe that's the 4th best record in the league this year. That's pretty bloody good, that. A plus 19 goal difference. The thing that did surprise me was that they had a better goal difference than us, so they must judge this on head-to-head. So we did finish second, but had to go up through the playoffs. We initially beat Menemen, didn't we? Then we moved on to De Rica, and then we had to play Kadıkspor in the playoff final, which, for those that didn't see it and don't want to go back and watch it, we won by 4-1 in a scintillating playoff final. Let's move on to some awards now, ladies and gents. Let's do the goal of the year. year, and you will see that Mustafa Inan has scored this, a top quality strike from the on loan Atlanta Sport central midfielder Mustafa Inan, as he scores a 25-yard shot which curled past the goalkeeper. We are going to see this later in today's episode, because he has won that in another thing in today's in this season. Manager of the year has gone to I believe this is this season's, yeah it is, it has gone to Ahmet Yavuz, who has got his Nazili team promoted. They won the league, didn't they? I'm gonna be completely honest with you now, I am amazed I am not in the top three. You think about what we have just done with this football club, and yet we're not in the top three. It's pretty incredible. But you know, I'm not bitter, I'm not gonna lose it over that. As far as player of the year is concerned, you'll see that that has gone to Marko Milinkovic. That's in the white group of the table, so obviously these awards do go for both leagues. And he's a right midfielder, 31 appearances, 6 goals, 12 assists, a really good average rating. That's a really good effort from that lad this year. As far as young player of the year is concerned, you'll see that Erdem Yilmaz has only gone and finished a second in that. That's a pretty incredible effort from the lad. You'll see from his 22 appearances, he scored 1 goal and got 7 assists. The man that won it, though, did have 28 appearances, 16 goals and 3 assists, and it's on at Nazili once again. Top goal scorer this season, obviously we've already seen that, a 19-year-old from minimum. He's actually on loan, and I'm going to scout him up and have a look at him, because he looks pretty decent, and I think he could give us some firepower in next season as we are going up a league. And then as far as team of the year are concerned, you have to remember this is over the white and red leagues. This is the team of the year. I'm surprised none of our players have managed to get in there. But remember, we did have a very poor start to the season. We are now going to move on to the club awards, ladies and gents. So let's do that. So here we go, ladies and gents. This is the club awards as voted for by the fans. And as you can see, the fans player of the season is Erdem Yilmaz with 65% of the vote. An absolute landslide victory for him. Nice to see Haluk Tekeri and Baturai getting second and third. I thought they were both very, very good for us this season. Young player of the season went to Erdem Yilmaz as well. And I did mention goal of the season, didn't I? And as you can see, the goal of the season that the fans have voted for was the same one that won him goal of the year in the league. So we are going to take a little look at this goal. It was a phenomenal effort from that man, Mustafa Inan, in the midfield. You'll see the throw-in comes in. Inan does lay the pass off. He receives it back in a moment from Gonan, and he takes a touch, and it's this one. And what a beautiful strike that is. I'm sure you'll all agree. And as far as the season's stats are concerned, we're probably going to go through this in a bit more detail as well when we look at the squad towards the end of today's episode. But Haluk Tekeri has finished top goal scorer this season with 16. Erdem Yilmaz has got the best average rating with a 7-3-1 and the most assists with 10. Ramazan Keskin had the best pass completion. What a six months he had with us on loan. Haluk Tekeri got 4 player of the match awards. You'll see that it's been shared between a couple of players, but most yellow cards, and a couple of players did pick up reds this season as well, just not when I was in charge, I don't believe. We had very good discipline after I took over. A few silly yellow cards were picked up, but we did pretty well. So before we move on and we take a good look at the squad, I just want to show you how the dynamics are doing with the squad. Now, match cohesion and the dressing room atmosphere have slowly been going up during the course of the season. We were having real problems with managerial support, though. But now that we've got promoted, it seems to have gone on the more positive side. You'll see there's a few issues with some of the players wanting first team football, needing to leave and all that good stuff. And obviously the summer is here, the transfer window is open, and some of these players are going to be allowed to leave. That will be said. Now, as far as the hierarchy is concerned, we don't have any team leaders, which I'm very, very surprised at this moment in time. I thought some of these guys would have stepped up a bit as they've taken on this season. But, you know, we can always go and attack the transfer market for something like that. And maybe these guys will improve even more. As far as the social groups are concerned, you'll see the core social group is the biggest of the lot. And yeah, it's slowly growing with each passing week. The team are relatively happy, apart from the players that are looking for, you know, first team football and all that good stuff. And the training as well seems to be causing some unhappiness throughout the squad. It's something that I really need to tweak with this team. I got it bang on with Vanersborg. It was just quickness training was all they wanted. But with this team, I haven't been able to get it bang on and get it just right how I want it just yet. If you guys want to see more stuff like the training and how I scout players and stuff like that, do let me know, and maybe in one of the episodes in the new season, I can show you that, or at the end of next season, I can go over it in real detail. I have already decided that every fifth year, I am going to do a massive episode where we look back on previous clubs. We also look back and see how other clubs in other leagues have been going and who's been winning what and all that good stuff. So maybe I could even do it and put it in that. They'll be slightly longer and extended episodes. Okay, ladies and gents, so we come now to the squad screen. We can take a good look at the stats of all the players over the last season. Obviously, some of these did take place when I wasn't here. Some of these players only came in on loan when I joined and all that good stuff. But we are going to take a good look at how the players got on this season and then potentially talk about who could be leaving and the sort of player we're going to be looking for to take on to help us next year. Now, as far as appearances are concerned this season, you'll see that Evren made the most appearances for the club, 41 in all competitions. We were out of the cup before I took over, so I didn't have a chance to get involved in that, but maybe next season we can have a little cup run. You'll see that obviously Gonan, Cian and Haluk Tekeri, all with 30 plus appearances for the club, all did very, very well, and there's a few others there very consistent throughout the season. As far as goals are concerned, we obviously know that Haluk Tekeri was the top goal scorer this season, but Gonan wasn't far behind. You'll see that Uj and Baturi, Murat, Cian all chipping in with goals, as well as Inan and Atunkai. They've all done a very, very good job. You know, there weren't even that many players when you look towards the bottom that didn't score a goal this season, and a few of them, only a few of them, really made a lot of appearances for the club. As far as assists are concerned, we know that Erdem Yilmaz is the top assister this season, but you'll see Cian with 9, Inan with 6, Gonan with 5, Baturi with 4, Youssef with 4. There was a lot of people chipping in this department. And as far as the average ratings are concerned, there's only 5 players with a 7 plus average rating. But remember, a poor start to the season for this team will have affected that. You'll see Erdem, obviously, with the best average rating over the course of the season with 7.31, but Mustafa Inan with a 7.16 is very, very good. Had a solid season for us once he came in on loan. Baturi with a 7.09 is very good. And Erdi Ona, which is a surprise to me because he didn't play a lot of football after we took over because we went to a 3 at the back, but he was playing very well before that. And Haluk Tekeri with a 7 rating overall from his 30 appearances, 16 goals and 4 assists. What a solid season he had. Now, as far as this team is concerned, I've already started making bids to bring players in on full transfers to try and bring people back on loan. As you can see, I'm going to try and bring Inan and Ramazan back on loan. I'm going to try and bring Gonan back on loan. I've offered Furkan a contract because he's out of contract, so we're going to get him on a free transfer. This guy is going to be let go, and Aset's going to be let go, and so is Sona. I know he played a lot of football, but not really up to the next level. So we're probably, we've got this guy, he's getting on a little bit. We're probably going to move him on. A lot of the guys that are over 30 potentially are going to get moved on. I like younger, more vibrant squads, so we're probably going to do that, but we are going to keep some of the experience. You know, maybe Takeri's going to stay on, Axe going to stay on, but we do need to strengthen. We do need to bring in some quality. It's probably going to be loans and free signings. I'm looking at a striker. I'm looking at a couple of wingers. I'm looking at a couple of centre mids, and I'm definitely going to be looking at some centre backs. I need to bring in a couple of fullbacks as well that are going to be happy to play backup and second fiddle in case we ever need to go to a 4-4-2 or a 4-2-3-1. We always need to have that backup plan. I know that the three at the back is working at the moment, but there's nothing set in stone that it's going to work in the next league. You have to remember, with, you know, each league that you get promoted in, the quality goes up. So you've got to be able to adapt your tactics as you go along. Okay, so the next thing we are going to look at, ladies and gentlemen, is the manager's screen. While we are here, we're going to click on Vanesborg shortly and take a quick look at them and see how they're getting on. But we are going to take a look at this and just see how we are slowly moving along. You'll see our reputation is the first thing I've noticed that has improved. We are up to 1.25 stars, I guess you could call that. I have applied to do my national B license. The finances of this club are so bad, they can't finance it at the moment. So it's a tricky one. As much as we love Bandırmaspor, if we have an okay season and at the end of next season they don't want to renew it, we may have to move on just to get coaching badges done. That's the problem that you face sometimes, because until we get that pro badge, we can't take the big jobs later on towards the latter part of this series and, you know, the way we're planning it. But for now, I'm very happy at Bandırmaspor. We just need the finances to improve because I need to get my national beat license done. But let's have a look at this. You'll see that all of these stats are slowly improving. Very, very good. I hate the fact that working with youngsters is only on a one because there's some young players in the squad and they're usually the better players. All of this is moving up quite nicely as well. Adaptability needs to go up a bit. We've never managed in England, so that should go up. That should mean that we are, you know, we adapt well to managing abroad. But we also haven't learnt Turkish yet, which is interesting to me, considering how well we were doing and we don't speak the language. But, you know, football is a universal language, I guess. As far as the career stats are concerned, you will see 59 games managed. It's mad to think we've done 2.5 seasons, I guess you could call it. We've done two seasons now. We did a half season with Vanesborg, a half season with Bandırmaspor, and a full season with Vanesborg as well. So yeah, two seasons in we are. We've only managed 60 games. It's pretty incredible to me that. But 37 wins, 15 draws, and 7 losses from those 59 games. 118 goals scored, 53 conceded. So a really positive goal difference there. And a win percentage of 62%. Now, I expected that to be a lot lower at this stage in the series. I thought the beginning of the series when we really struggled. But at the moment, we are doing really well. As you can see, we've got a new career milestone added here as we are runners-up this season. And we are going to be promoted once again, which is pretty decent stuff. I'm pretty sure if you look on the job history, yes, you'll see we finished second. No awards, but we are going to be going up. And lovely old job. This is why I've had to do 2.5 because it's technically still part of this season. It's a bit strange, isn't it? This is a good little screen to be looking at as well, my friends. You'll see a breakdown of what we've done here at Bandırmaspor, and this is my overall career. So we now have 2 promotions, 1 league title to our name. It's all going very well. A 77% win percentage with Bandırmaspor. That is pretty incredible, isn't it, ladies and gents? But let's quickly go back to the profile because I want to click on Vanesborg and I want to see how they're getting on. So they're 9th in the Swedish Division 1 Södra, which is south, I do believe, in Swedish. So yeah, 9th, places about here, 14 points on the board, 3-point gap between relegation. They're actually going pretty well, aren't they, ladies and gents? I'm really happy for them. Vanesborg. Oh, one of the old favourites is transfer listed. Oh dear, one of the other favourites is transfer listed. Martin Anderson's still there. Nice to see. Musa Tahir still there. Iglikar, Kajo. So they got some of the old boys are still there, not scoring the level of goals they were when they were me, though. If you're actually looking at that squad, they've only scored 6, 7, 8 goals this season. Wow, they need to inject some firepower in there if they want to get through. But they're going all right, aren't they, ladies and gents? And as far as the Hall of Fame is concerned, ladies and gents, it has stayed the same. It hasn't changed because we haven't won anything. I know a promotion, you would think you would get some points for that, but you don't technically win any silverware. So we are still, you know, marked down as 1 Division 2 Norra Gotland with Vanesborg. We need to be winning titles, don't we, if we want to put some points on the board, because with 12 points on the board, we are very far off even entering 20th place, which is 1903, held by Antonio Conte. We have work to do in this series, ladies and gents, but we've had a great couple of seasons with Vanesborg and Bandırmaspor to this point, and we're going to have another brilliant one, I'm sure, next year with this wonderful little Turkish club. So there you have it, my friends. We are done and dusted here for another brilliant episode of FM19's The Hall of Famer. I know this was just a little review episode. Some people like this, some people don't. I think this is necessary in this kind of series because it keeps you up to date with everything that's happening. Obviously, we're trying to get coaching badges. We're trying to get on the Hall of Fame. We're trying to, you know, move around Europe at the moment because we're trying to pick the best team to help us do the best thing. Bandırmaspor at the moment are near and dear to my heart, and I really hope we can sort the finances out so they can help me do my coaching badges. I don't want to leave this club at the moment. I really like them, a bit like I did Vanesborg. They just didn't, you know, offer me a new contract, which was heartbreaking. But next season is going to be massive in the next division in Turkey. It's going to be a lot harder, and I'm pretty sure that the levels of difficulty are going to be ramped up, ladies and gentlemen. But do join me on Sunday when that new season gets kicked off. I'm sure you're going to get introduced to some new players and some new teams, and yes, it's going to be amazing. But until then, my friends, if you're new to the channel, like, share and subscribe. If you're an old timer, share with your friends so we can get the community massive. But I've been Dan, you be legends. This has been FM19's The Hall of Fame. Peace out, my friends. I salute you all. And I'll see you next time when our new season, our third season in the Hall of Famer, gets kicked off and we go once again. Laters, my friends.